People often ask me how to do the perfect clap. A lot of people have been doing the clap wrong. It's time for you to learn. Start slow. When you hear the drum, you clap. I know it's complicated, but focus! It looks like you clap with the deltoids, but you're really clapping with your heart. Straight, beautiful arms. Keep a straight face. No smiling. Clap with deltoids. Always have a barrage. Clap! Then it goes faster, and you clap faster.
Group E began in Reykjavik with a Scandinavian derby between Iceland and Norway. Two teams who know each other pretty well, of course. They met in qualifying for the European Championships. Norway won both games on that occasion. And after 20 minutes, a bit of a shock for the Norwegians as Iceland took the lead. Oh, very simple stuff. They lost to Norway. Coach will not have enjoyed seeing that. The long throw from Grøtje Larsen found his way through to Harry Arneson, who was able to turn it in. That is something of a disaster for Norway at the back, and certainly for their goalkeeper, Espen Pedersen. Long throw hurled in, and Arneson was able to get on the end of it and just scoop it into the net rather apologetically. But Iceland had the lead, and Norway were looking to hang on at this stage. Remained at 1-0 to the home side into the second half. John Arisa floated a free kick in. It all got a bit scrappy. Substitute Joshua King drilled the ball into the net. Norway thought they were level, but it was ruled out. King's effort actually struck a player in an offside position. Well, that was a let-off for Iceland, and they took full advantage, extending their lead with just over 10 minutes left to the young striker, substitute Alfred Finnbogason. Only 19, playing his football at Herenveen in Holland, considered the natural successor to Ida Gudjonsson. He got this one-on-one chance on the break. After a through ball from Sigurdsson, he made no mistake. And that wrapped up one of the more eye-raising results of the night. A surprising win. Second international goal, only the second goal that Switzerland had conceded in the group. They looked for a response and they had one inside the first 15 minutes. Granit Xhaka's cross headed home powerfully by Stefan Lichtsteiner. The Juventus defender with only his third international goal on his 59th appearance, glancing it home past Hannes L. Dawson.
And it was all square. It looked like normal service had been resumed for the Swiss when they took the lead. A bit of a scramble here. Liam Seferovic's shot was turned in by Fabian Scher, the Basel defender, making his first start for his country. It appeared as a substitute in a friendly victory over Brazil last month. And in the starting lineup and on the score sheet. And when Switzerland made it 3-1 inside half an hour, the Hitzfeld side were coasting home. Lichtsteiner, not a regular scorer, but he was tonight.
Tuesday proved a night to remember for Iceland as they sealed a place in the European qualification playoffs for the FIFA World Cup for the very first time. Needing just to match Slovenia's results in Switzerland to make history, they made a dream start against out-of-contention Norway in Oslo. The spine of Lars Lagerbäck's team coming up with the goods once more. Tottenham's Gylfi Sigurdsson threaded the ball through to Kolbein Sigthorsson, and the Ajax striker made no mistake to send the visiting fans wild. But their joy wouldn't last long. Some impressive interchange play culminated in Daniel Bratton prodding Norway back on level terms less than 20 minutes later. Didn't matter as Slovenia lost 1-0. It meant Iceland did just enough to move towards the verge of World Cup qualification for the very first time. Should they win their playoff, the North Atlantic island would become the smallest nation ever to qualify for the competition.